Studied English Literature at IP College TU, pursuing MA English at Hansraj, attempts both prose and poetry in Hindi and English. She's been part of various anthologies too. I now call upon Udita Garg.
Hello everyone. A very good morning to all of you. I present a poem that I've recently written. It's titled Fragments. Sometimes the left eye cries alone, without suitable assistance from the right. It will laugh terribly, or it might have a little smirk in the sarcasm of life. When wine-colored tears smear your face, the eyes illumine, wake out of a holy calmness of the perfect union of subtlety and extravagance. Cold feet, cold hands, numbness of mind, this trance of extraordinary dreams that makes one believe reality is neither what you hear nor what you see. An aching heart is better than this cold, aching mind. Unable to think, compose, poetry is an illusion, dream, hallucination, the perfections of an imperfect mind. Where then it becomes impossible to work without ideas, rationality, composure. I do not understand these fragments, a life of disassociation from the mere fact of being lofty, not in ideas, but in size. Of having people look away when they see you are a lump of flesh unsuited to them. When you're never loved, maybe desired, remember only partly, like your eyes or smile. What do I possess to reveal or to hide? When they expect a certain dressing from you, never are eager about what you might wish. When they deny you simply care, a cup of espresso or high heels, sugar, honey, butter, ice creams. Tell me, with no love around, how else do I sweeten my life? Unread, unloved, alone. What I live with is loneliness and disillusions as my power of mind. But why this? Why a huge mass of entangled words to untangle a bunch of cold-ridden ant feet? Prohibited the luxury of high heels. Is it not enough to smile dryly and wear that whole disguise? I'll present a shorter one. It's titled Me and You. I cried in a memory last night, memory of the woman that I love and can never have. My only friend, my lover. She smiled there, and her eyes remind me of her dreams that I shared once, but not anymore. I have changed, and she exists only as a memory, once to touch the impalpable I craved. But I lost her months back. All her smiles, playfulness, pranks, and her exuberant self-confidence. She perhaps did love me then, in all her mischief, had me in her heart. I craved her lips, her touch, a kiss, and yesterday, in some soul-quenching, I remembered her soul-wrenching fingers. I felt the desperate will to coax and cajole me, to separate her from this me. We were never one, except physically, for we are one, only the same body. But the souls are different, one of her, the other belongs to me. I loved her and I lost her, the woman that was me. Thank you.